PHASA 35 breaks the aviation paradigm because every other aircraft that you look at today takes off with sufficient fuel to fly its mission. We don't. We can sit over a location for weeks and months on end doing ground observation, providing communications, and we can return our steerable satellite to the ground, replace its payload and launch it again. And that's something that you can't do with any form of satellite. It's a completely different approach to aviation than what we've seen in the past.
The stratosphere is obviously a fairly hostile environment itself, but the challenge here is we're trying to get to the stratosphere with a solar-powered aircraft, and that means that you have to get through all of the weather in the troposphere.
The air pressure in the stratosphere is 10% of what it is at surface level. There's not a lot of air, so the ability to generate lift and drive propellers to give propulsion is extremely challenging aerodynamically and demands an extremely lightweight structure.
Really here we're understanding what the sensitivities of the vehicle, of the aircraft and its flight plan are to changes in the weather and how to not only avoid those weather hazards but also exploit the weather to be able to get up through the weather to the stratosphere where it's a bit calmer for flying.
Working with the UK Met Office, we've now cracked the technology that allows us to mission plan through the troposphere because we truly understand and are able to accurately forecast the weather systems.
I'm Ellie Bates. I was the autopilot operator on Crew 1. First time I've ever been autopilot operator on the actual big aircraft. And it was quite intense. The autopilot has the means of measuring really tiny differences in error, which could ultimately mean a huge difference in the position of the aircraft in the sky. And it can do that up to 400 calculations a second, which is just beyond what a human could do at that altitude.
I'm Jamie Hope. I'm the GCS commander for Crew 1 of PHASA 35. So I'm very much an overview of the entire crew, so I'll sit at the back and look at all of the screens, getting all the information from the crew, taking in all of that knowledge and making a plan based on that.
We knew there was going to be a lot that we didn't know, but the way we have trained our teams is such that we are not just following procedures, we have trained to understand how the system works.
The data that we'll get from this flight and what we've learned as a crew about how to operate this aircraft is all going to be fed into the next flight. So we want to achieve greater things with the next flight, and that's going to be an endurance, you know, flying for longer. And it's all looking exciting for the future. It's not every day that you get to be a part of these kind of projects that are sort of pushing the boundaries of what's possible. So it's an incredible privilege to be a part of that.